Lord help us.
Mother, mother, there's too many of you crying.
Oh, brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. Welcome to episode 6 of What's Really Going On, here in beautiful Tampa, Florida at Flo-Hio Radio Studios. I am Tommy C, and in front of me is my amazing co-host, Truth Davis. What's up, Truth?
What's poppin', y'all?
And the man that allows us to be here every Tuesday from 9-11, Mr. Surge. How you doing tonight, brother?
Fantastic.
Good, good,
absolutely good. Fantastic.
Good, good. So how has everybody's week been?
So far, so good. Nothing major.
Pretty much we can't do anything.
It's still Tuesday.
Yeah.
Give us some time. Give us some time.
We can't.
We had Sunday and then Monday. Yeah.
Well, from last Tuesday since we've been together.
It's been great.
Can't complain. Still healthy.
Yep. No. Completely free of the good old COVID.
Yeah, I'm negative for the second time. Praise Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
And they got rid of those nose test things.
Ooh, good.
Thankfully.
How many of those did you do?
I only had to do one. Ugh. And when I heard about them doing it every 2 weeks when you work at any old folk place.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, I'm about to quit because I'm not sticking that in my nose every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And they came, what was that, last Tuesday?
Yep.
Yeah, like last Tuesday. And they were like, oh, you ready for your test? I was like, nah.
Not at all.
She's like, no. She's like, it's the swab. All they got to do is swab your mouth. I just looked at him like, sure? All right.
You ain't playing, right. Archie.
All right. Because I was just about to grab my stuff.
Like, I'm out.
Yeah.
I don't want this.
I know we're about to serve lunch, but yeah, I'm definitely out right now.
I'm done now. I'm done. No, I understand. Pretty much I work and watch my daughter. That's about it. that's how my week's been.
Sounds like the life of a parent.
Yeah. But this is my little getaway. 2 hours to get away because work has been crazy. I got people on vacation and I'm running all over the place, but besides that, it's been a good week. So are you ready, Truth?
Yeah.
All right, let's see what's really going on in our news world today. Good lord, we have a lot of news today, a lot. I know people think that I might bash our great president. I don't. I just tell you what I see, what I hear, and then I tell you what I feel about it. But this is coming out of his mouth, not my opinion. My opinion comes after, but what I tell you is what he says. Let's start off with our great president, and his press secretary denying an aide sending out opposition research against Dr. Fauci. So, you know, it's an election year, and right now the virus is not doing what everybody thought it was supposed to do.
Yeah, I thought it was supposed to be gone by now.
Yes, so now our president's saying we are beating it. But Dr. Fauci is saying that it's not getting better. It's starting to get worse.
I was about to say, then we have 15,000 new cases.
That's just in our state. That's our state. That's our state.
That was 2 days ago. I don't know. It was 15 and then 12. I didn't catch the number today.
I think it was another 10.
I thought it was 11,000.
Well, but you also got to think these numbers are like from 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. Well, so. Now you're getting the 4th of July people that was...
just getting their results back?
Yes. So you have all those people that were out there. Even though they're saying their protesting didn't cause a lot of this either, I think it's a mix. I think the protesting was probably about 2 or 3 weeks ago.
I thought they said that the protesters... that there wasn't a...
The first
increase.
The first spike happened right after 2 weeks after the protest. After the protest was heavy. The next big spike happened now because of 4th of July. So, and now Florida numbers and pretty much a lot of the southern states numbers are running really high. I think this is a campaign move because he's trying to save face with a lot of the states with high numbers. Because he's bringing up old stuff that, like, even when Dr. Fauci said in the beginning about the face mask. So face mask won't really do anything.
Did he have a face mask on this week?
Our president, yes, he did wear a face mask to Walter Reed.
First time ever.
Yes. But I'm going to say he probably gets tested 25 times a day. He probably already has the vaccine, which I'm still not taking. But that's neither here nor there. But, yeah, so right now, pretty much if you see his press releases or whatever things he do in the coronavirus task force, you really don't see Fauci up there. See Dr. Birx, because she's kind of more on their side, kind of saying, it's okay, we've got a little flares here and there. But when Fauci comes out and said, yeah, guys, it's not good, it's pretty much going against what the president says, and it's like, I don't want to look bad, so we got to put you somewhere in the corner. So I think Fauci's right now in timeout. So, but we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. Good old Canada. Oh, Canada, land that I love. We can't go there. We cannot go there for at least another month. Canada says
they're going to build a wall.
Yeah. Let's see. Mexico's already starting to work on their wall because they don't want us coming down there. Canada's like, okay, we're going to work on building a wall up here. So, yeah, so guys, so if you want any poutine or want to see the Niagara Falls on the Canadian side, Toronto, any of those places, you got to wait another month at least. So, I'm sorry, I know people like poutine and...
Maybe, you know, a month.
Yeah, the way things are going...
They might be like, none of y'all coming over here.
Well, probably what's going to happen is they're going to probably separate the country in half. All the northern states, yeah, y'all can come over, you know, just take your temperature and then you're good. Southern states, y'all stay home. Y'all ain't going nowhere. So that's what's happening in good old Canada. So we can't go to Canada. I guess there was something going on with some of the online schools. You know, United States have a lot of international students that come over here to learn from Harvard, MIT. Well, no, they're well, the thing is, they're wanting to come back into the country so they can finish their studies.
Oh, so they got sent home when all this... Well, no,
they went home. They went home, you know, and now they're trying to come back. But the president and his administration was trying to block that. They're saying that if the universities can do this schooling online, the international students, nah, y'all can stay home. Y'all can't come into the country. But they dropped that because two of the biggest Ivy League schools, Harvard and MIT, did put in a federal lawsuit to put an injunction in for the president to try to do that. So that has been taken off the table. So international students can come back into the country if they want to. I wouldn't. I would stay home. I wouldn't come to the United States right now if I was out of the way. So, okay, whoever got in the shower, sorry. So international students can come back. So that's good. So we don't have to worry about, you know, kids that want to learn, they can actually learn here in our country, even though I wouldn't. New York State. Me and Truth's home state. Governor Cuomo.
Yeah, he a real G.
He just... Well, I'm a preface this with this. He's a G, but he did have some missteps as well.
Mm-hmm.
It happens. Players mess up.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Players mess up.
Yeah. But people that are coming from hot zone states He also threw in Florida, because I guess Florida's its own little country right now.
Pretty much.
Have to fill out paperwork, self-quarantine for 14 days, or you have to pay fines up to $2,000. So, this is why I'm like saying, okay, I understand you're trying to keep your numbers down, but why didn't you keep your people at home and let them come down here when you started shutting down? To me, I'm sorry, if people would have stayed home, if you would allow them to travel, I don't think that it would still be as bad, but probably not as bad.
So, in your opinion, do we need to shut the country down again?
Well, we should have shut the country down in the first place. We should have took a playbook out of New Zealand. New Zealand's having fun now.
Yeah, they are.
New Zealand's having rugby matches and everything, and their full stadium's full bore. They shut down for 2 weeks straight, like nothing. I'm talking about very few essential places open.
And then the virus just disappeared from...
What they did is they methodically started slowly opening places up. Slowly. I'm talking about not just like, oh, like how Florida did. Oh, level one. All right, we can do this. Level two, we can almost open up everything. I'm talking about they took a methodical approach, and they made sure there were no new cases. They haven't had a new case, I want to say, almost for the past almost 5-6 months. But she locked it down. Their prime minister locked it down. She gave them time to get their stuff. She said, y'all can get your stuff.
Essentials.
But anything else, close. And they're pretty much back to normal. But over here, we have people that want to say, oh, it's taking away from my freedom. It's blah, blah, blah. I want to get a haircut. I want to get this. I want to get that. And people placate to that and made it more of a political stand instead of a safety stand. And that's why a lot of places did, like a lot of the northern states, they kind of shut down and kind of said, we're going to rein it in a little bit. Southern states really didn't. And as now we're seeing the effects of all of this. But to me personally, if I was president, I would have shut down the place. I would have shut down everything. I'm like, everybody has a week to get what you need. After that, we are shutting down for 2 weeks. And then we will have a plan to come into place of how we will come back from this. If we would have done that, I think we would be in a greater position than ever.
Yeah, definitely.
We wouldn't be talking about, oh, are we going to have a football season? Are we going to, what about schools? No, we would be fine. But again, everybody, pretty much it's more of, there's no real leadership. It's pretty much everybody has to figure it out. Instead of coming together and figuring it out together, oh no, you got to figure it out yourself. You got to figure it out yourself. It's not a group to come together on this. So we'll see what happens here in the next few months, few weeks, few years. A lot of people don't know about Roger Stone.
Who's that?
Roger Stone was a Trump ally that was formally charged, with intimidating a witness and also lied to Congress about emails that were stolen in the Russian investigation, which showed that Russia was involved in meddling with the election that got President Trump elected. His sentence was commuted.
Yep.
Oh, his friend?
Yeah.
Who was just supposed to turn himself in like in a week or something?
Yep.
Commuted. Yeah,
friends in high places.
Must be nice, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So literally, it's like, it kind of never happened. And it's like, okay, he was charged. Formally charged. Not just, oh, we have, you know. And he was going about to serve jail time. I think he was going to serve 3 to 5 years.
Yep.
Nope. But his friend said no.
Yep. So now,
I said, good looking out, bro.
Yeah. But now here's the problem.
Appreciate you.
Here's the problem. What does Stone have to lose now if he decides to say, hey, You know what? Yeah, Russia did hack the servers at the DNC.
I doubt it. He's probably just happy to be free.
But no, he's communed.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think he can be charged again either. No. I think that's what they said.
Because that'll be double jeopardy.
Yep.
So he can come out. He can literally stand on the White House front lawn during the press conference.
But will he?
We'll see.
And
we'll
say,
see.
I did it.
Yeah, I did it. I did do it.
What you gonna do?
And take me to jail.
No, you can't, because double jeopardy. Because I was charged and I was convicted of my crimes. And I've been commune. So we will see what will happen. And I want to say a quick shout out to Dave Wyman, former employee of Fleet Pride in Lakeland. He just gave me a shout out on my Facebook Live, so I want to say hello. Let's see. Let's jump into our good old National Education Secretary, Betsy DeVos, which has no education background at all, except $20 million that she gave to Trump for his campaign.
Where are these people at? I just need like 50,000, like 100,000, like
exactly.
Yeah. Jeez,
they give it away millions.
So yeah, so she
$20 million.
So pretty much, she got a position because she gave him money. And
you better give me a position. $20 million. Shoot.
But she was. They had a good interview on CNN on Sunday. The CNN interviewer, I wish I had her name, but she went ham on her. She pretty much was asked, you know, Betsy DeVos saying, you know, kids need to go back to school. Kids need to be in brick and mortar schools. They need that interaction with other kids. She asked her, what is the plan? What is the plan? What is the plan that you have for sending our kids back to school? First, she said, she reiterated again, kids need to go back to school.
Yeah.
That's what she said first.
Okay, so she understand that part, but she keeps what going do you back mean? To
like, but literally, if you watch the interview, it's probably about 5-10 minutes of her saying that a lot.
Ma'am, are you stoned?
I'm surprised she didn't ask her that.
I don't understand why nobody does ask that. Like, how are you there? I'm like, okay, so now that you've said the same thing twice, can you answer the question?
And then this is her quick answer on this. Well, all the districts have their own rules, and we're going to let them make their own rules. But you're the national education secretary.
Look, I don't want to deal with this. I would prefer everyone else in their own states and their own cities to deal with this. Thank you.
Then that's pretty much what she's saying.
And all the kids need to go back to school.
Yeah, but they need to go back to school. They need to be
Listen, kids are being harmed at home.
It's like... But
that's true.
That's my favorite one when they say that. Oh yeah, do you understand that kids are getting beat at home? Cool. So let's send them to school.
Yeah.
To get a rotavirus, come back and kill the parents.
Exactly. And then your grandparents, or you know, or the kids themselves, because they have underlying conditions.
Yeah, they might. Exactly.
So that's what's happening. All the kids that have died so far, they're saying, oh, they have underlying conditions. But
what was the number? 5%?
Oh, 0.05%. Yeah, she said like, oh yeah, and that's what she did. She's like, how many kids do you think are gonna die from this if you send them back? One. Oh, we're looking at, yeah, it's like,
that's it.
So you are willing to put 19,000 kids' blood on your hands.
Listen, it's just the Emily Arena population. Yeah. You know, it's nothing big.
Yeah, but it's like, it's like, oh my god, just...
She obviously doesn't mind.
No, she's pretty much placating to her boss.
Yeah, they all are. It's a shame.
And that's all it is they're placating to him, so he stays happy and he doesn't fire him. Which, he's been on a firing spree, so he's been firing a lot of people.
You're fired.
Here we go. And good old coronavirus news. The biggest thing that's happening, there is an FDA investigation happening at a lab in Texas that Advent Health, which is one of the biggest healthcare systems in Florida.
Yeah, they did kind of just take over, like, every hospital.
Yeah, but the Advent Health was using this lab called MicroGen DX in Texas. FDA is investigating from unsafe practices with the testing of the coronavirus. They're saying that 60,000.
Who do you trust at this time, boy?
Well, they said 60,000 tests have been compromised. Because the rule is, when you get the test, which they were actually trying to sell home tests, which have not been approved by the FDA.
Get your home coronavirus test.
Yeah, and they weren't approved by the FDA or their state health board. And they say you should ship them back by FedEx. So you telling me to send it? Oh, let me just get a next day air envelope and put it in there. But the rule of thumb, what's
sounds
the
legit?
Well, what the rule of thumb of the test is, it's supposed to be when you get the test, you're supposed to keep it refrigerated at all times. Then when you get it into the lab, you're supposed to freeze it. It's supposed to stay frozen so it does not get contaminated. So what they were doing is they were just leaving it out on their tables.
Letting it get all warm.
Yeah. So now you got all this stuff growing on it. And now it's messing up the test. And now they don't have an answer about possibly 60,000 tests. So 60,000 tests might have to be thrown out. Just say, dude.
Do we know whose tests these are?
These are from,
so they can be retested.
You know, there's no answer for it. There's no, they don't have an, again, oh, no man. Answer. And then on a little extra.
I'm so over Corona.
I know. I am
so
too.
Over but, Corona.
But it's what is.
I just want the world to go back to normal. Like, I promise I won't take advantage of traveling and going places.
I want to go back to February.
I will not. Invite me. I want to go everywhere.
I will not take ODS for granted.
I want to go back to February where
you
can still do
things. I
will
never stay home again.
February, you were still able to do stuff.
Yeah.
I went to Texas for my job and was able to have, you know, staying in a great hotel.
The government needs to stop playing.
The biggest thing is wait till November. Yeah. Wait till November. We'll see what happens after November.
Well, the second wave is going to hit. Right?
Yeah, we'll see.
And everything's airborne?
We'll see. We'll see what happens in November. Oh!
Hey, where do you get one of those bubble suits?
like Bubble Boy?
Yeah.
I don't know,
I need one of those.
They got those that you can play soccer in them.
Yes, they do.
I need one of those.
Those are fun.
I'm sorry. I can't come to work because if I can't fit in the hallways, I'm sorry, but I'm not taking this off.
But
until this is over, I'm not taking this off.
But, Moderna, which is, I guess, the company that got a big grant for testing a vaccine, their stock shot up 16% because they're saying they're having great success with trials. Which I looked for.
That's interesting.
And I looked for hours looking for their stock ticker. I couldn't find it. I could not find it. Like, I'm like, man, I need to invest in this because if they get good results, that's money in my pocket. That's like extra
money in the bank.
Yeah. So we'll see what happens with this fake vaccine, but we'll see what happens. Now we're going to jump to good old Florida. Florida, Florida, Florida.
Florida.
Ronnie D. Ron DeSantis, our governor, says that things are getting stabilized.
I don't even think he's here. I don't think he's here.
He's green screening from
Pennsylvania. Yeah, he is not here. He's not in Florida. He has no idea what's going on. It's like he's in the middle of playing video games every day and someone that's like, yo, press conference time. You gotta say something. Just say something. Come on.
So you think they actually got the hologram system set up so well that it looks like him sitting there.
Because him and everybody else obviously are not looking at the same numbers and seeing the same things that are going on in the state of Florida.
Well,
so,
I know. Well, he said that things are getting stabilized. Well, over last week we shattered our state record over 15,000.
When they heard 15,000, I was everybody go home.
Yeah, that's
everybody go home. We going back to the way we were acting when this first started happening. And
we were all paranoid.
Like, yeah, exactly. Somebody was coughing, and he was like,
"Yeah, looking at me.
Should I hit you in your throat now or later?" Like, you know what I mean? Like. Yeah. We got to get back to that mindset.
Yeah, but it's too late to go back there because we 15. No, it ain't. 15
well, start spraying people with Lysol in the face. Start no. touching the handles of the doors like with cloths. No, look, nah.
No, yeah, so, you know, we've been averaging between 10 to 15,000 positive tests during this last week, with 15,000 being our record right now.
I want somebody to test the stoners.
To see if that... If
yes, they, I want to know if the stoners are getting corona.
Not because they're too busy at home getting stoned. They going nowhere.
We're just staying inside, bro. We're not going outside.
But no, so...
Because I did, I mean, I heard rumors about, you know...
Well, you know, they're not going to say anything about that because that's going to be taking money out of their pocket.
What kind of rumors?
There are rumors that there were certain plants...
Like
CBD
always.
And THC.
Imagine that, right?
Yes. That imagine is, that.
Can't do that because both of the guys running don't want that legal.
Yeah. So
I
we
mean,
have,
me personally, I personally, myself, don't know anybody.
Well, I'll tell you what. If somebody can give me a test, I'll take it right now because I'm full of THC.
I'm saying, I'm. What if that's the key, yo? What if that's the key?
It probably is.
It's a natural. It's gonna say it's natural, and it's been demonized because it's natural, and they can never find out how to make money off of it. They're slowly starting.
Yes, they can.
Well, no, they're starting to figure.
Tell Colorado that.
Well, no, they're
trying to hood that. Like, the hood will show you how to make money off of it.
Well, no, but they can't. But they can't put that money in federal banks.
Oh yeah, that's true. That's right.
They have to keep it. No,
that's
they can't.
Okay, we got personal banks. We ain't gotta put it in federal banks. Well, that's okay.
But that's how you would make more money off of it.
So how does California not make money off of...
They're making money off it, but you can't even make more money because what happens is you loan... Banks, all you do is loan your money out here and there and you make an interest rate on it. That's all you're doing. That's what banks do. That's how banks make...
Federal bank. Bernie don't care about no federal bank. The cookies, man. He don't care about no federal bank. They offered that man... Oh, I was watching the interview. They offered him like... What was it? $700 million.
Ooh.
Yes. $700 million, and this was years ago for his cookies empire. He said no.
He wants to keep the money himself.
Yeah, smart.
How much money? Yeah.
But
yeah.
Still, it's his money.
Man, $700 million.
That's just like Chappelle walking away from 50. That's,
yeah, but he ended up making that
back. And yeah, that's $700 million.
Twice as much.
Yeah, so, but... So
he got the antidote,
and then
Burner got the antidote.
But okay, with the 15,000, literally after he said that the state's stabilizing, we had the most deaths in the state with over 130.
Hold on, got kids. His kids going back to school?
No, his kids are not going back to school. They're too young. Okay. They're too young to go to school.
Oh,
he said
they babies.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, but he said
if he's not sending his kids back to school, then nobody else should be sending their kids
back to school. But this is what he said though. He said if his kids were school age, he wouldn't have a problem sending them back to school.
You can say that when your kids aren't school age. It don't matter. Like, I would say that to him, you know, if they were.
Well,
it don't matter because, you know, they're one and two.
That's
so.
Like me saying, you know, well, if I had kids
and
they were of age to go to school, I would send them back.
Yeah. Wow, these people are crazy. These people are insane.
So, and then about that, schools are opening. They are still, schools, they're pushing to have schools open. But... I had some news that happened today. Found out Polk County, they pushed their opening back 2 weeks. Sarasota County.
To clean the schools?
I don't know, clean the schools or reevaluate.
Hire teachers?
Probably.
Because a bunch of them about to quit.
You better hire some 12-year-old teachers.
No, I saw something on the Pasco County site. They're not calling them substitutes.
Yeah, I forgot they changed the name to it. Yeah, I seen that. I need to find that.
Sacrificial lambs? Is that what
you're calling that? But it's like, it's three tiers, and if you're a retired teacher...
Yeah, yeah.
If you're a retired teacher, you get more money.
Okay.
If you're a current teacher, no. If you have experience in like 2 years or more...
You get a certain level.
Yeah, and then you could just be somebody starting out with no experience, and I think...
You get like $100, like I think it's like $75 150 and then like a percentage.
Because they know. They know they might as well.
Because they putting their life at risk.
Yeah.
So.
Of course.
But they putting that out there because they already know they're going to have all them teachers somehow know.
But you know what our great governor has called schools? Schools are considered essential businesses. Because he compared schools to Home Depot and Walmart. Well, people can be in Walmart and Home Depot.
They do be selling cookies at school, though.
But no, but he said if people can go into Walmart and Home Depot and shop, kids can go back to school. But the problem is, how long are you in Home Depot? How long are you in Walmart?
You're there for like maybe 30 minutes.
30 minutes. You gonna be?
Well, guys are.
Yeah, yeah. Well, Home Depot, we probably about an hour, maybe tops. But kids are going to be sitting in the classroom for 7 to 8 hours.
Oh, they're not doing it like China? Because I saw a video of China where they had the kids and they had little boxes built.
Why can't they just like do 4 hours on, 4 hours at home? Like, you come in the first half, I do my 4 hours, and I go home and do the other the four on whatever online thing. Yeah, that's true. Yep. That's true.
So
either buses or parents would have to break into their schedule.
Yeah, we didn't even think about that. Bus drivers.
Yeah. Yeah. So
and you know what? Another situation that's, and you know it's going to happen.
Oh, you can build them. You can build.
But just
them
listen. We are in a situation now where kids are assholes. They like to do things for clout. They like to go online and do things. So, how long do you think, over under 10 days, is it going to take for a kid to go cough on a teacher?
I'm going under.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm going under. I'm saying 5.
I think right now they need. They're
gonna do that.
Because coughing on somebody should be considered like assault.
Assault, yeah.
Well, it is. If you spit on a law enforcement officer.
No, if you spit on somebody.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's assault.
So they. Yeah, we need to work on. I don't know.
I just see it happening already. Like, there's gonna be kids that. Oh, look! I'm on TikTok. Watch this.
Yeah.
Newest challenge.
Yeah.
The newest challenge, cough on a teacher challenge.
Yeah. Watch.
Look what we done did.
Exactly.
Well, actually.
We're going to see that real soon.
Cough on a teacher challenge. That's terrible.
Actually, about TikTok.
Yeah.
There's been a couple companies that have told their employees to take off TikTok off of their phones.
I thought this was already a thing. I thought if you were a government official,
yeah, they took
that
it
you
up.
Weren't supposed to.
Well, yeah, government. Yeah, government. Well, I'm talking about private now. Amazon sent out a memo, which they now have retracted, telling their employees to take it off because it's something that with their tracking everything on your phone, stealing data and everything.
Yeah.
And then Wells
Fargo. Same as Facebook.
Yeah, but actually, theirs is a lot deeper. There goes a lot deeper.
Oh, yeah, because somebody, I seen a guy.
He reversed it, yeah.
No. He didn't reverse it. A guy, he uploaded videos and pictures on TikTok, and then he saw an ad, a Chinese ad for a sex pill. And it had his face on it, but they owned his pictures and his video because he uploaded it on TikTok. Yeah.
Now, you so, and that's why people, they're saying.
Y'all need to look at some of these Chinese sites and see if y'all pictures and videos.
That's why Wells Fargo said take it off. Fargo's now said take it off. They
can't blame them
because now you know they're at work doing a TikTok video, and they're somehow by a computer or something. They could just
hacking our information.
Pretty much
done. So.
Well, new memo, guys. If you have TikTok on your phone, you got about 10 seconds.
Can I be Mr. Conspiracy Guy? I think it's a little ironic, maybe coincidental, that 2 weeks after this guy's rally got shut down because he had a million people that were supposed to show up, and it was because of the people on TikTok, all of a sudden, 2 weeks later, now TikTok is a problem, even though Facebook mines way more data than TikTok does. But it's okay because that data goes to the United States government.
Yeah, not to Chinese.
But they're not, because it's Chinese. Oh, so that's the problem now, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, so I promise
might
you.
Might have something to do with
I guarantee it has something to do. Because they weren't saying nothing about TikTok. They a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, so.
Now all of a sudden.
You TikTokers shut my rally down.
Yeah, exactly. So I got something for you. So.
I'm just saying.
Y'all know Big D don't play.
I'm just saying. It looks. That's how it down. Looks from where I'm standing. That might not be it is, but
no,
I'm just saying.
That
from
makes sense. I forgot the TikTokers. Yeah. Shut them down.
Well, let's hit the school, little bit of school news. Today, I got a message from Pasco County. Masks are going to be mandated at all, at school, everybody.
Good luck with that.
Only time the kids can take them off is to eat. That's it.
Yeah, I'm telling you, there's no kids. I promise you. They're going to be, here comes the mask off challenge.
Yeah. First you got the cough on the teacher challenge. Which,
and then the mask off challenge.
You don't wear your mask, you're going to ISS. Oh, ISS school.
Yeah.
Boom.
No, they'll call the parents, and the parents are like, ah. And a lot of it is parents have not become parents. They're more friends.
Yeah.
And that's the problem. If parents would stop being friends with their kids and being parents, I think a lot of that would go away. But right now, the parents want to be just as cool as the kids. So, I'm sorry, we need to step up as parents and say, we're not going to do this. We're going to do things right. And yes, it will ruffle people's feathers, but I think if we become parents instead of friends, kids, I think, will be a lot better.
Yeah, I agree. Well, I don't know. I don't have kids, so I can't even say.
And then, my final news story, Grady Judd, America's new sheriff, got reelected.
Really?
Guess who ran against him?
Himself?
OJ?
Nobody.
Yeah, of course. It's real easy to get reelected.
So he is.
So we're just gonna throw a party because you won.
So now he's sheriff for 4 more years. But you gotta say, his stings, when he does his stings and he goes on the news.
Yeah, he gets
it. It's like
he talks a lot.
Yeah, and he throws dirt on him.
Yeah,
and I'm learning, Grady's equal opportunity. You don't care if you're black, white.
No. If you're a criminal, you're getting it.
You're getting it in Gradyville. So
yeah, he's going to tell you about it.
Always minding my P's and Q's in Polk County.
He got a
Polk
whole
County areas.
Polk County is on lock.
What he told people, the looters, come out, people have guns.
Yep.
And they will shoot you. And I'm advising them to shoot you.
Come up, go up.
He's like, I'd rather send a body bag than deal with court and, you know, taxes and panicking these people locked up. No, go ahead and shoot them, guys.
Yeah, if they're breaking into your house, you have a constitutional right, and I'm backing it. So I was like, all right. So
Grady said, blow them out their socks.
We'll come get them after. So, I forgot. You remember the meme of the month last month?
Which one?
Karen and Carl.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. there was a warrant out. They had their guns confiscated.
Is that legal, though?
Yeah. Why?
See, because now that bothers me because
they took their guns for what purpose?
They were the ones that were out front when they were doing that march to the mayor's house.
Yeah.
Oh, whose son got the dub for like $60.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gotcha.
So
what's brandishing? Was that?
It's got to be. Well, she had to be brandishing because she was literally she was pointing at people.
He was more standing at a guard.
She was like,
just waving it around. Like, if she would have just stood guard, they would have
been fine.
My pillows are $200.
$200 pillowcases.
You will not come in here.
Do you know how much this grass costs? Bermuda.
So Karen and Carl, they lost their guns. But we'll see what happens with them.
Yeah, because you can't be reckless.
Sure they got more.
Oh, yeah. No, they took them all. They found them all. But they probably got a safe somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
They got a safe somewhere that they didn't hit. So that is all I have for the news segment today. We're going to jump into what is going on in our sports world.
Oh, boy.
Is there even sports?
There's a little bit.
I just wanted to see Melo get drafted. That's it.
We got a little bit. Not a lot. Because, like you said, there's really nothing going on in sports besides sports getting canceled and stuff.
They're not in Orlando?
No, they're in Orlando.
Oh, okay.
Big news. Russell Westbrook. Positive for the COVID.
Oh. No.
So,
it's over?
No.
Well, it's 14 days, so.
14 days. It was right before he flew out to head to Orlando. So, right now, he is self-isolated. He is sitting at home. But they said he said he will be back.
Where do all these carriers come from that have no symptoms? Like, when did
I don't understand it either.
Yeah,
I
mean,
the asymptomatic.
Yeah.
Well, it's weird because you're hearing more and more about asymptomatics instead of people that actually.
Yeah, and they're like, "Oh, I'm all right. I feel good. Yeah. You know, it's all good." But you can pass it to somebody else. You have to self quarantine.
Yeah. So he will be back, but he said he is promising to be back by the time season starts.
Did his watch let
him know? No, he didn't get the watch.
Oh, okay. I'm really anxious to see how those work.
He did not have a watch, so I guess he got tested before he left, a few weeks before he got left, and then that's when they found out he was positive. Let's see what else happened. Good old NFL. Got a couple of stories in the NFL.
Yeah. Let's talk about it.
First, before we get to the deep one, there's a deep one. Oakley came out with a new face shield for the NFL.
Really?
Yes. It's a plastic guard that goes over pretty much where the mouth is.
Yeah.
It's a plastic guard that covers the whole area where pretty much it keeps the drop, you know, the spit and stuff from flying out. So it's clear, so they can, you know, it gets
no more spitting in each other's mouths. Like
no
a dog pile.
Yeah,
good.
So
good.
But now here's
I didn't think that was too healthy.
Now is that still going over the actual like grill part?
Yeah, it's going over the grill part.
Okay, I thought it was just be clear.
No,
that would be cool.
Yeah, well, I know they can still have their little the clear visor pieces they want. But the actual, if they have like the regular helmet,
so it'll go all the way down.
Yeah, it'll go all the way down. So it's, you know, some players are like, okay, we'll do it, and then others are like JJ Watt's like, I don't really want to wear it
because you don't have a choice.
Yeah, if you want to play, you gotta have to wear it. So
wow, that's interesting.
So we will see what happens there. Timothy, you're true. Sorry, okay. Well, I apologize.
Government.
Do you remember a wide receiver that played for the Buccaneers named DeSean Jackson?
Yeah.
Yes. What did he do in the Super Bowl?
He got into some stuff this weekend.
Yeah, who got some heavy stuff this weekend?
What, like some meth heavy?
No. He posted some anti-Semitic post on his Instagram page about something Hitler said, saying that blacks were the two children of Israel.
I saw that. And it's facts, though, but Hitler didn't say that.
Well, yeah, they were saying a lot of people used that argument to show that Hitler wasn't a racist.
Yeah, I saw that.
And then
how many people died?
6 million?
Oh.
6 million. Also, he had a video. He kind of...
You know, we need an internet quarantine for like a week.
For real.
Like, seriously.
Nobody's
like
alive.
Exactly.
I'm lying.
No posting.
The next 2 weeks.
Nothing.
But then he you know, kind of apologized for that. But then he puts a video of a speech from Louis Farrakhan, another very anti-Semitic person. He's the leader of the Nation of Islam in the United States.
He's not anti-Semitic.
Well, he's not, but that's what
the American media wants you to believe.
Yeah, they want to say it. But they're saying, I guess there's a speech that he's talking about. He's saying how Dr. Fauci and Bill Gates are trying to depopulate the earth.
Yeah.
So
I believe that.
I believe it too.
Yeah, I definitely believe that.
But a lot of people still believe.
That's why I believe the second wave. Like they're like, you know what?
At this point,
not kill as
they're
many
spraying.
People as we thought.
I swear,
like,
they're spraying it at this point.
Yeah, because I feel like Donald. What, remember when the CEOs, all of them, said toodaloo?
Yeah, they all quit.
We forgot all about that part. Mm-hmm. And Bill Gates has been advocating for years about the population needing to be cut in half. So you just decided you were going to leave your billion-dollar company and you were going to go get on your hydro yacht, and you were going to work on philanthropy work.
Yeah.
Okay.
And what continent does he start in?
Yeah, like in
Africa.
Yeah, where are you,
well,
sir?
We're going to go give them all. Oh, we're going to give them the vaccine first.
Yeah.
They're the test market.
This is definitely population control, and like I said, I feel like.
Ooh.
Not enough people that they thought we're going to die and get it. And now it's like, all
and that's right. And that's why I say this: why they're sending the kids back to school, because who is that going to affect the most? The low income people.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Because the rich people got insurance.
Yeah.
They'll be okay. Oh, I'm starting to get sick. Let me go on over to the doctor.
Or they can stay home.
Yep. Now you got the low income people. Oh, I'm starting to get sick. I ain't got insurance.
I still
got
to go to work.
What can I do? I still got to go to work.
So
I don't want to get my conspiracy mode, man. I really don't.
We'll say that for a little later.
Can we talk about sports?
Yeah, we will.
Listen, I'm going to bring something into this that I saw today, and it made me so proud.
He's actually a Holocaust survivor, Edward Mossberg, invited him to come to Auschwitz.
Who? Oh, okay.
And
yeah.
And Deshaun said he's going to go.
Yeah.
He's going to go. He's going to go. And I believe he's genuinely sorry about it. A lot of people are saying, oh, he's doing this just to...
Yeah, he was catching mad heat for it.
Yeah. But a lot of people are saying, oh, you're just doing this to save your career. 50-50 could be. But if he can learn from this, I think it'll be better. A lot of people are saying there should be more outrage for it because, you know, it was against Jewish people. It was anti-Semitic talk. And it's like, let's just try to work to become better people and work together.
People are bored.
I think that's what
and
it
all
is.
All people have time to do is be on YouTube and watch videos. I know because I'm one of those people on my damn blog. I find myself
in the YouTube hole.
Yeah.
The rabbit hole.
Hours at a time. And I'm like,
no.
Well, I thought it was still morning time, but it's afternoon.
No, I'll tell you this.
I've been there.
I'll tell you this my rabbit hole on YouTube, for some reason, is car crashes. Just people that just do dumb stuff driving.
You know what mine is? Runaway tires.
Oh.
But if you break down a runaway tire, that is meant to hit you if it hits you.
Oh, yeah.
Because you could literally be 5 seconds slower and be safe.
Mm-hmm.
Or 5 seconds quicker and be safe.
Yeah.
But that moment, that tire just happens to hit you.
Boom.
It was meant to be.
So you watch videos of tires spinning and hitting people.
Falling off a car is going down the road and just smacking into somebody. That is the scariest thing ever. Like, I don't... You know what I do when I go walking up the road? I as far away from the street as I can.
Because you're looking for tires.
Because I feel like there's a tire coming. There's a tire coming and I need to get away from the road.
Better to be safe than sorry.
For real. Those are the worst videos ever.
Yeah. So Madden 21 comes out this month.
That's about as much sports as
yeah. there's two big things that has happened. Your quarterback for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, Mr. Tom Brady,
yes,
has broken a record
already.
How?
Madden.
He has. What, he got 99?
No, he, please.
There's no way.
I'm about to say, there's
no
way.
No, his rating is a 90 this year. It's a 90. Well, you gotta say he's 42 years old.
Yeah,
he doesn't have the mobility like he used to have.
Why is it 90? Exactly.
But I guess it's more mental now.
Okay.
But for over 17 years, he has had a 90 or better rating.
Really?
On Madden.
Nobody's ever done that.
Nobody has ever done that.
Well, because nobody's played 17 years.
Yeah. So he has the record for the longest 90 or better rating on Madden.
Put him on a cover.
So,
that's all I want.
So,
curse.
Put him on exactly.
Well, no, Pat. No, it's not a curse because Patrick Mahomes broke that curse.
Oh yeah.
So
no, that was the same year.
Yeah,
where they won a Super Bowl.
Yeah, last year.
Oh,
20. Yeah.
Yeah. You know what? Yeah.
And about Mr. Mahomes, he is the only quarterback that has the 99 rating.
Oh, he got 99?
See, I knew somebody was going to have a 99 rating.
Yep. So,
and he got a 99 rating in that bank account, too.
That's crazy.
Mr. Half Billion, yes.
Mr. Half a Billion?
And guess, but
oh,
guess,
my God.
But guess who was the quarterback behind him with a 98?
Don't say anything. I don't want to say Dak. It's not Dak. It can't be Dak. Okay.
No. His name is Russell. Last name Wilson.
Really?
He has a 98.
What is old boy from Baltimore?
Baltimore, I think he's number three, like a 97, 96. Okay,
I see that. I'll put him above.
But I guess
they're not going to give him that respect. No. It's like year three.
But I think the problem is the way people are going to use him on the game, his speed is 99.
Oh, of course.
So
his speed is 99.
His speed is 99.
No, he's like the Michael. This kid grew up watching Michael Vick.
Yeah.
And he is.
And his throwing.
Lamar Jackson. I keep saying this kid. No, yeah. Lamar Jackson. Props to you, bro.
Yeah. But yeah, he's the. And plus, he is the cover kid. Cover guy on Madden this year.
Is he?
Yes, he is.
Good.
So he.
I mean, he's got all kinds of stipulations in his contract.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's still on his rookie. He's still on his rookie contract.
Yeah.
So,
you can't do that. All you can do is stay home.
But here's the thing.
You can get carried. You don't have to walk anymore.
Good. We put him on the cover.
Somebody to carry you, but, preserve your legs.
But this is what's going to happen. If they can win the Super Bowl, he's going to probably get a similar contract than Mahomes did.
They won't.
Or he can come down to Tampa Bay and then lead Tampa Bay.
They'll never get that record. Not playing against Cleveland this year. Can I say it? I saw it today.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Cleveland Browns are ranked number two offensively this year. As far as weapons, not including the quarterback. Number one is Kansas City, of course.
Yeah.
Number two is Cleveland Browns. The Bucks are fourth.
I'm telling you,
because you remember I said Cleveland against Tampa Bay in the Super Bowl. And I love how they put Lamar Jackson on the cover.
Because the curse is on
that
him.
That curse is coming.
He's going to run one time and get his leg broken.
It's a wrap.
Just like RG3.
And all of a sudden, Browns are winning the division.
Because there's no way Pittsburgh is going
to
do it.
We're winning the Super Bowl.
We're going to
the Super Bowl. If there's a season.
We are going to the Super Bowl.
There's a season. There's going to be. I think the way things are going, there's going to be a season.
It has to be. They're too greedy not to let it happen.
Come play Tampa.
No, they're going to have a season. They're just not going to have any fans there.
Yeah. Or they're going to like say.
Half capacity.
Yeah, half or 25% capacity. And you got to sign.
Realistically, like, you know.
See, but now how would that work as far as, like, what season ticket holders get the first picks? Or
maybe they
should.
Because you can't. People who can come and watch.
The problem is, and with the Bucks especially, there's been a lot of issues about the seats and the season ticket holders. Because a lot of your season ticket holders either are going to be close to the field or in the boxes. That's where they're at. But they're tarping off, I want to say, the first 10 rows.
Not to be near the players?
Yes.
Smart. Dude, that's going to be...
But now that's the problem now.
I'll be so mad if I pay for those seats.
Yeah. And that's the problem. That's the problem.
And now. I heard they're not giving refunds.
That's correct.
How can you not give
I
refunds?
I would fight.
How can you not give refunds?
Especially if you're a seeking...
Man. That's crazy.
Contract.
Oh, my God.
Contract. You
oh
signed the contract.
I would fight.
You sign a contract.
Can you imagine
that? You drop 10 stacks on some season tickets
that you can't even use? That's good when they get that box.
Oh, you want to sit close to the field? Well, no. Guess what? Now
that's insane. That's crazy.
And
please show me your COVID disclaimer in this contract that I signed. It says that this 10 grand that I put out for these tickets... Now I don't get back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'll be school.
I see y'all at every game.
They better
game.
Not do that.
I'll be sneaking in. I'm telling you, I will make your life a nightmare.
I don't think they would do it. I think what they'll do is they'll give the season ticket holders, you pick whatever seats you want.
Yeah.
And then they'll go general admission sales. Yeah. And at that point, it'll be like playoffs.
Yeah.
Whoever they pick, they pick.
Yep. So, because
I would fight somebody if I spent 10 stacks. Ooh. And you tell me I can't even.
We almost decided to get some people to get a box. We almost decided to get a box this year.
I'd be full of great ideas.
We'll get one. There's gonna be a Flo-Hio box eventually.
I'm down for a box.
Down for a box.
Boxes.
Everybody we got in the network, we can make a box happen. And they give you free food.
Yes, they do.
I'll be in there just to eat chicken sticks.
I was all the way down to the menu. Everything. It was free parking. You get in early tailgate before all.
We should talk about amongst the team and see. Well, maybe next year.
Next year. So
I am with that though.
So we'll see what happens with Madden.
I did a baseball box one time. And
I just hope. Hey, pray to the Madden gods, please. Madden curse come. This is all Cleveland sports fans. This is our moment. This is the end of the world. The end of the world is coming. Dear God, please give give us a chance. Let's be in the Super Bowl. That's all. Thank you.
And give the Bucks one last Super Bowl win, please. Thank you.
No, let them go there. But we got to win.
No. We need a win. We need a win.
Browns ain't got no Super Bowl championships. We need at least one, man, right before the world ends. Browns win a Super Bowl, aliens show up, roll credits.
That, my friend, is the end of Jumanji. It's over.
Game's over. And I'm going to throw a little bit college and NBA again. Colleges. A lot of your HBCUs, your historically black colleges and universities, canceling a lot of their fall sports. Albany State, Morehouse, and Langston University have canceled all fall sports. Big news, Power 5 Conference. The Pac-12, I guess they're Pac-12. It used to be Pac-10. I don't know what they call it.
Yeah, they got 12 now.
They are only staying in conference only.
Yeah, everybody, all the major conferences are going to do in conference only.
So, and I know as of right now, I was reading, I haven't heard anything yet. The SEC, which is, you know, God's country down here.
For real.
That's God's country. They're having meetings, you know, today and then tomorrow talking about if they're going to follow suit.
They will. Because the Big Ten was the first people to do it.
Yeah, so they're looking at, you know, all right. So there's no USC-Alabama game at all this year, which everybody was talking about. That was going to be the big opening of the season game. And then also, in NBA news, they showed three cover arts for NBA 2K21.
The Kobe one. That's the one I'll buy.
The Mamba Forever. Yeah, that one.
I'm buying that one.
That one looks amazing.
I haven't bought an NBA 2K game, I want to say, since Bron came back to the Cavs.
Well, actually, since I have PlayStation Plus, I downloaded 2K20, and it's actually pretty good. I've been playing it lately.
Oh, that's the most recent one? Yeah.
The most recent one, yeah. I got it for free, so. And it was nice. I like it. They have a My Team option on there where it's almost like how Madden has the Ultimate Team.
But so you can just pick, like, an all-time?
Yeah, well, you get cards and stuff, and you build them up. But the only thing I don't like about it, you can only use the cards a certain amount of times because they have contracts. So, yeah. So, like,
for more DLC money, right?
Yes, exactly.
Of course.
Exactly.
I'm not going to get it.
Because I have Vince Carter, Devin Booker, and Lonzo.
You on PS or?
PS. Okay. I'm PS4, yeah.
Damn. Yeah. I got Xbox.
I know.
But
literally, hey, you gotta get what you can get.
What you get. Yeah. Other than that, I got a PS4. I mean, PS3.
But literally, I played last night, and I made it to the last challenge where I'm playing the Clippers. Which Clippers team on that game?
Yeah.
Ooh.
I believe it.
Ooh. And literally, I can only use Devin Booker once because he had a one-game
contract. Now, what do you mean use him once?
Well, it's like a card system like Madden. With the Ultimate Team, you get cards, but they have contracts where as how many games you can use them.
Okay.
So if you run out of contracts, you pretty much got to put them on the bench until you get, you know, a contract card and pay money to get the contract.
That's crazy.
So
back in my day, you should play whoever's on the roster.
Exactly. But you have the Mamba Forever cover. You have the Dame Lillard's on it. And then they have the rookie one with Zion. So that's the three covers they have. But the Mamba Forever one.
Yeah, that's going to be the top seller.
If you get a chance to look at it, search NBA 2K21 Mamba Forever, that cover is amazing.
Yeah.
And Mamba Forever, because, you know, he was turning, you know, his life to fatherhood and being a great father and how you say that word?
Philanthropist.
That word, yes. And, you know, he was doing something big and he was taken too soon. Rest in peace.
And you know what? They still don't give him enough props, man. All you hear is LeBron, Mike, but never Kobe. And I'm like, I put Kobe over Mike. Personally, that's just me, though.
Kobe, I think you have Mike in the one generation.
Yeah.
Kobe took over.
And then LeBron
and
after.
Then LeBron came after. But yeah, Kobe pretty much took over a whole generation.
And he's only had the greatest last game ever.
Yeah, yeah.
God. Just chunking. I was watching that live crying, like literally crying.
It's like you'd never see him again.
Yeah, because it's like, wow, like That moment alone is the Disney movie.
Yep.
Like, just to come out and put up 60
yep.
on your last game.
Yeah, exactly.
Insane.
So, rest in peace.
It still hasn't processed to me that he's gone yet. I know he's gone, but it's still like, nah, there's no way.
Yeah, it's like, I'm going to pop up somewhere. Yeah. Right? And,
He's in Barbados escaping.
For real, he's not.
He's with Tupac down there.
Tupac and Cuba.
Did y'all see that video where it looked like was really Tupac? He was wearing like a yellow raincoat or something.
Yeah, I seen that one. Yeah,
looked right into the camera like, if I was Tupac, that's what I would do.
In Cuba, though, come on, Cuba.
Why not? Because they can't extradite him.
Yeah, it's got to be somewhere else to go beside Cuba.
Yeah, but Cuba's right there, and his aunt was there.
So
like, he got family there.
Familia. So, that's all I have in the news world today. So now we're going to jump over to truth to ask her what's really going on in the entertainment world as we speak.
Who knows?
Oh, this is going to be fun.
First time.
Oh, my God.
Entanglement.
That's my last one. My first story is about Mr. Kanye West. He has reportedly withdrawn from the U.S. presidential race.
You can't withdraw from something you're not officially in.
Well, guess what? He has withdrawn, and his family is saying that he is suffering from a bipolar breakdown, which is what caused him to announce his presidency in the first place, which makes a whole lot of sense.
Wait, what? What?
You know what? I'm running for president.
They said he suffers from bipolar breakdowns at least once a year, and this is his bipolar breakdown. And during his bipolar breakdown, he announced his run for presidency.
When did his mom die?
His mother dying definitely contributed to him losing his mind.
No, I'm talking about...
I don't know the year, but...
No, I'm not talking about the year. I'm talking about, like, the time. Like, is it around this time of year?
So you mean the date?
Yeah.
Let's Google it. Let's find out.
Because I think that might be a biggest contributor.
That could, because if it's around the same time of year every year.
Yeah.
Like, if it's around Christmas or something, that's going to every time mess with you. Every time.
I just want to know.
They said he had 0.2%.
Oh no, she died.
Points in the polls.
No, he gained 2 points in that.
2% though.
Yep.
I'm in that 2%. I don't even care.
She died November 10th, 2007.
Yep, right around this. Yeah.
So
we're off a few months, but still.
I mean, losing your mother—that's something that never goes away anyway.
No.
So
no.
But he is suffering a bipolar breakdown, and his family is seeking help for him, and he has withdrawn out of the presidential election. Which I'm glad, because we ain't got time for them kind of distractions right now. So
you mean you wouldn't want Kanye to be president?
Yeah.
Why not?
College dropout Kanye, I would want to be president.
This is what I was telling you about.
Late registration.
This is what I was telling you about. I believe he's still in there.
No.
He's been playing everybody. You but say, hey,
this man is so far
let me front
gone.
Like
He's
I like this guy
breakdowns.
So I can get. They're calling it a mental breakdown.
Nah, that man got mental breakdown. Like,
I just believe he's
or
a calculated genius.
Or is it something deeper that they're trying to keep us not knowing?
What? Like they got Kanye programmed?
Like he's a robot.
Manchurian candidate.
Yeah. Monarch? Project Monarch? I believe it.
I couldn't see myself voting for Kanye. I just really couldn't see it.
Okay, so if you had the two people that we have now and Kanye, who would you choose?
I'm writing somebody's name on.
Yeah, I'm going with Kanye. Bottom.
Or would you go for Joe Jorgensen, libertarian?
I don't even know who that is. Everybody
know Kanye.
Exactly.
I'm sorry.
I can see Kanye getting up one day and being like, you know what? We going to war. How about that? I got the buttons right here.
Kanye's not that type of guy.
We're going to war.
Kanye's not that type of guy. Kanye's the type of guy, he'll yell, but as soon as you, like, perfect example, when Sway was like, oh, we ain't doing that here.
I think because he had a little bit of respect for Sway is what it was, which why he, you know, calmed down a little bit during that interview. But if this man is the president of the United States, no.
I'm with it.
No.
I figure if the world's going to end, we might as well end it with Kanye as president.
Oh, nah, I don't know. I don't know if I want to go down that fast. I want to kind of slow it down and, you know, kind of coast into an ending. Yeah. But nah, I can see us going, him having a
light. What would be worse, President Trump or Kanye? Because, like, right now, we're in a bad situation. So let's just swap out Biden, throw in Kanye. Who would you vote for?
I don't want to say I would not vote because that's, like, not the right thing to say. Hey. But
Yeezy 2020, let's go.
I don't know.
It's sad, right?
Kim K is the
she'll be first lady.
Yeah. I mean, it's not much worse than the one we have now.
Exactly.
But
Well, you seen her statue?
Why Michelle didn't run? Why?
She seen what her husband went through.
She saw all that. She's like, I ain't dealing with that.
Yeah. You see when he walked in, he had nice black hair.
He still
looked good. And then when he walked out, he looked like he aged 10 years and went all gray.
He still looks good. All right. Oh, and sadder news. Naya Rivera.
I saw that.
Her body was found, I believe, on Sunday.
Yes, it was.
And it officially concludes the search for her. According to CNN, what they believe happened is she had enough strength to save her 4-year-old son and get him back on the boat, but not enough strength to fight the currents and get herself back on there. So, as any mother would do in that situation, she sacrificed her life
for his kid,
for her son.
Always.
This is a very sad situation.
It is.
It's just very sad. Prayers for her family and her little boy.
Her little boy that literally had to watch his mom.
Yeah, because 4 years old, what do you tell these people? Mommy never got up back on the boat. Like,
yeah, exactly.
It's crazy. But her castmates from her former show Glee, they started a fund for her son. And will be providing, I believe it's a college trust for him. So
that's good.
Naya Rivera, y'all might remember her from being acquainted with Big Sean for quite some time. They were engaged to be married before he cheated on her and with Ariana Grande.
Who?
No. Big Sean.
He went. Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know he did that.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was a downgrade.
Yep.
No offense.
Yeah, for real. I was going to say, hey, I will second that emotion.
Ariana Grande.
Damn.
So, and apparently Taj Mori, which I had no clue until I seen.
He's on my TNT.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. The smart guy?
Yeah. He posted a bunch of stuff on Instagram about regretting not being able to tell her that he still loved her and
loved who?
Naya Rivera.
Wow. And so I didn't even know they were a thing.
I didn't either until I read that and I heard the story, and he said that he wished that he would have took the time to tell her that he was still in love with her, and he wished that they could have made it work, and
I didn't even know they were dating.
Me either. Me either.
I didn't know that he grew up. I thought he was still like...
That man was like, seriously, when it was like Taj Mori, I'm like, click. And it's like, oh, he's 33 years old. I'm like, how? How is that even possible?
Wow.
All right, rapper Tory Lanez.
How about before you move on, but how about just the weird coincidence that they found her body 7 years to the day where the other castmate killed himself?
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
It makes you think.
It's weird. It's like...
It might be that Glee curse. It might be a Glee curse.
Glee's got a Maddie curse?
Jeez.
Glee got a Maddie curse?
Because I know... Who was it?
Three of them died so far.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the guy killed himself. The other one, I don't remember.
Yeah, the main guy that was on the show, the main guy. Yeah, he killed himself.
I never watched it because I don't like musicals and
But you know about it because it's so popular.
It was a popular show back in the time.
Wow. Yeah, that's crazy. Tory Lanez was arrested
for what though?
Gun charges.
Again.
Oh my god.
Either guns or drugs.
Is that a stereotype there?
It's not a stereotype, it happens.
Well, he was arrested in the early hours Sunday morning. He was arrested and charged for carrying a concealed weapon in his vehicle. It was also reported that Meg Thee Stallion was treated on scene for injuries. One website reported that it was for a gunshot wound to the foot, and another site reported that it was for glass in her foot. But apparently there were gunshots from the vehicle, and it was reported, and when the police got there, they found Tory Lanez with a loaded gun in the car. So, yeah.
And was this in Cali?
It has to be.
Yep. They were in L.A. Ooh. And I guess about a few hours before that, Kylie Jenner was on their live. They were all on live.
So they was all hanging around.
Yeah, just chilling. So I don't know what occurred.
So how did a gun get pulled out? Like, what is...
I guarantee you probably got pissed off at something.
Oh, people.
No, actually.
It's the Rona. Why can't you just chill?
Hold on. I got the story for y'all. The incident began at a house party and proceeded to an argument in an SUV.
Okay.
Police were able to locate the SUV accompanied by two stars and an unnamed woman and reported finding a gun inside the vehicle.
Okay.
So, Tory Lanez was charged on felony charges, which I believe this is like his second felony charge this year. And he was released on a $35,000 bond 6 hours later.
$3,500.
So, I doubt we'll be hearing the real story of if Megan was shot in her foot if she has glass.
That's going to be
something. I'm willing to go out of... Well, I don't know. I'm not going to make any accusations, but it doesn't make any sense.
If she shot in her... Nah, here we go. We're going to see when she...
Maybe he just pulled it out and Cheddar bobbed her.
You shot me.
I didn't mean to. I was just pulling it out. Sorry.
All right.
I'll drive you to the hospital. Woo! Ah! And then pull this over. It smells like gunpowder in here.
You owe me 5 records. 5 number 1 records. I'm not playing.
And then he's like, fine, I'll do what you want. The cop's like, what happened? Oh, I got glass in my foot.
That's it. I can walk, though. It's okay. It's okay. I can still twerk. It's all right.
Oh, Lord.
Lisa Marie Presley's son.
Oh, yeah. I heard about this.
Jesus.
Benjamin. I'm going to butcher his last name, so I'm not even going to say it. Lisa Marie Presley's son was found dead from a gunshot wound, self-inflicted gunshot wound. He is the grandson of course, the late and great Elvis Presley. I guess the story of money can't buy you happiness.
Pretty much.
Never can.
But I'm telling you, if y'all give me $10 million, I promise I'll smile every day. Like, y'all will never see me frowning.
Now, you'll be smiling, but it'll be a physical smile.
Look. Money will fix 97% of all my problems that I have right now. 97.2%. And the other percent, I'll go to counseling and figure it out.
We'll fix it.
But yeah, Benjamin, 27 years old. He was also a musician who got a deal back in 2009 worth $5 million. Dang, okay.
Good catch.
Seriously, $5 million? That ain't bad.
I'm talking about good catch on you.
Oh, I wasn't even trying to wash my mouth. But now that you told me, I should be up $40 these last 2 weeks. Just in case you watching, Sugar Plum. All right. Now, this story we talked about a few months ago on Truth Radio, Pop Smoke.
Yeah.
They supposedly, so, and I say supposedly, found his shooters because this story still makes absolutely jack no sense to me whatsoever. How this man was shot in his Hollywood home, well, rental home. He did post his address earlier that day on IG after receiving some gifts from, like, a designer or somebody. Somebody sent him some clothes or whatever, and he posted the address. And middle of the night, he ends up shot. All intruders escape, and we don't hear anything until right now. Literally right now. So, wow.
Breaking news, breaking
the
news.
The LAPD, everyone. Well, it's not really breaking news, but the LAPD has, what is it? 3 adult males and 2 juvenile males in custody for Bashar, which is Pop Smoke Jackson's murder. Now, here is my thing. A couple months ago, we talked about the fact that Pop Smoke took a very expensive car from coast to coast. Borrowed it from a, I ain't gonna say mobster, but you know, somebody.
Pretty much.
Somebody that's very well connected.
Somebody on the other side.
Yes. And that's what we believe the link was. But apparently it was these individuals and 2 juveniles. I'm not buying it.
Yeah. Like, it's called scrubbing.
They scrubbed it. Now, what I do believe happened is these mobsters said, hey, we're going to go approach some people and we gonna put the move on them.
Yep.
But I also believe it was an inside job because I don't understand how a house full of people, it's a house full of people and the main man ends up getting shot.
And nobody
Where
else.
Is everybody else? And then a 911 call didn't even come from the house. It comes from New York after a member of his team made a call to New York, I guess, to let whoever know what was going on. And then they called the LAPD to let them know that there was a shooting in the home.
That's too many.
Yeah, it's way.
That's too many inconsistencies right there.
So
something, something's up there.
I hope the money that they paid y'all was worth it.
Because they're going to scrub. All they're going to do is just scrub. And watch. And if you start hearing some of these people mysteriously dying.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
Definitely. It's going to be scrub, scrub, scrub. That's what they do.
Eating in the mess hall.
Stab, stab, stab.
Yep.
Poke, poke, poke.
Poked in the neck. And Pop Smoke News also. His album was released with 50 Cent being the executive producer. It's actually a pretty good album. And let's see. I'm trying to think of his name. Why can't I think of his name? Casanova has approached 50 Cent and would like him to do his album if he should ever happen to die. Before his time, he wants him to do what he did with Pop Smoke.
Is 50 Cent now the Post Malone executive producer or something?
I think at the end of the day, 50 got that bank and
big time.
Oh, yeah. And could make just about anything happen. Make SHIT.
There you go. That don't count.
Make it glitter, so yeah. Oh, goodness. Now, dun dun dun.
Entanglement.
Now I know. Everybody has seen Red Table Talk with Jada and Will. I watched 3 times actually, because I felt like I might have missed some things.
You're gonna get every last detail.
Actually, I watched it for the first time too.
Man, okay.
I felt sorry for Will.
Yeah, me too. Me too.
See, now we all gonna clash here.
What do you mean?
We're all gonna clash.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, now does everybody feel bad because it's a Fresh Prince? Or does everybody feel bad because he was actually done wrong? Now, for those of you who did not listen to the Red Table Talk, which is so many angles, because I feel like Will Smith, like, he, like, dead got her on camera to admit her infidelity. So if I'm trying to divorce you, you done already told the world that, you know what I mean, that you, you know, that you had an entanglements with other people.
Entanglement with but August.
Now, entanglement with August. I didn't like her wording. She was aggravating. It was very aggravating because
she just
he's like, you need to say what you did. Well, what do you mean? What do you want me to say? I want you to say that what you did. Oops. My bad.
She killed me.
Now, Jada got on Red Table Talk and admitted to the world that her and August Alsina were involved in an entanglement.
Yeah, her.
That is the word for the rest of the year, yes, until something comes out that is better. She admitted to the world that she had an entanglement with August Alsina only after lying about it about a week before. Yeah. Now, when the story first came out, she said, no, absolutely, it's not true. And then she said she needed to bring herself to the red table.
Yes.
Yep.
From pretty clear understanding, they were separated. For whatever reason, Will, he said out his own mouth, he was done with her.
I had nothing to do with I was done. Yeah, I ain't think I was done. Ever talk to
exactly. Now, if you to the point where you're not going to speak to somebody ever again in life, y'all, it's dead. It's dead.
But then what should have happened then is proceeding should have happened. If he said that it's done, we are done, we can't save this, then, like I said, I don't condone divorce, but if you feel like you need the divorce, start proceedings. Because I guarantee they both got prenups.
Do they? Fact check it. I don't know. Well, they should, because he was already into money.
Yeah.
I mean, pretty much.
She wasn't doing too bad either. But not where he was at. Yeah. But still.
But my thing is, they weren't together. They obviously went their separate ways and did a great job not showing the media what was going on. But, I mean, this woman, she admitted her infidelities. And there's a lot of women bashing Jada. A lot. Which, I'm not going to bash nobody because I'm not in a position to judge anybody. But, I mean, is she wrong? Gentlemen.
If we are getting our space.
Mm-hmm. Like Ross said on Friends, we were on a break.
Then yeah. I mean, I don't see nothing wrong with it. However, situation was kind of thing to me, man. That's your son's friend.
I think that was something that was thrown into it, because I don't ever think it was a Jaden and August was hanging out type of thing. I don't think it went like that. I think people just identified it as that because of their closeness and age, you know what I mean? But I don't think it was ever, because even in the interview, they both speak about, like, inviting him into their family, you know? Because
they found out he was real sick.
Yeah, dealing with his health issues and stuff like that.
But still, yes, you are separated. If you do go on a separation, to me, you should see if there's anything left before you start looking separate, going separate ways.
But can't that possibly include going somewhere else? Because, you know, people always assume, like, you know, grass is greener on the other side once they get out of relationships. But if you're really to the point where you're in marriage and it's like, okay, this might really be ending. Like, how do you...
But I just think if it's not going to work, get out of there.
Okay, so what if she said, okay, let's start the divorce proceedings.
Yeah.
And then a month later started a relationship with him. Still wrong?
I would say it's not wrong because
at least they got the ball rolling.
You got it going. The process is starting. There's no going back after the process is started. You get the lawyers to draw up the paperwork. You're getting the lawyers to draw up the paperwork, do all that. Okay, you know now that there is no saving this. When you're separated, there's still a chance.
Yeah, we're just because kind of
you take a time apart to really reevaluate what's going on.
But the way they separated, both of them spoke as if they knew, like,
yeah,
they that did. Was the end. They like did. that was it.
But then that's on them then.
I mean, you can't really file for.
I think what it was is I think August just blew up a spot that was not supposed to be blew up.
Yeah. Look.
He caught feelings.
I didn't post it, but I said y'all mad at Jada. I'm mad at August.
Yeah, he blew up the spot. He blew up the spot.
Well, he's the pretty much the other not the sound not
the he's a side piece. Oh,
yeah, no, he's a side piece.
But the side piece.
Spoke. But people are saying women say he was abused.
Yeah,
by this older woman who had complete control over him.
See,
because apparently he was on drugs. He had health issues, and apparently he was on drugs really bad.
Now yeah. And a lot of people say it. Flip the script.
Oh yeah.
Flip the script.
We don't want to flip the script because not the Fresh Prince doing it.
No. But you have to. Yeah, you heard. There's women going after Jada about what happened. If Will did this,
everybody would go after.
He would be sacrificed.
How old is Harley Quinn? She grown?
Yeah, Harley Quinn's grown.
She grown, grown.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I forgot about that though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I seen that story.
Yeah,
about she him. Grown, grown.
I seen
she
the pictures. Grown. I seen
like
the pictures.
30 grown.
Yeah. Margot okay. Robbie?
I was just making
sure. Shout out to Slick Willie.
You know, exactly. You know what
and
I mean?
If you heard him, I think what it was, and this is just me looking at the situation. Will probably got caught up in something. She was not having it. She's like, well, I'm taking some time. He realized I messed up. Eventually got her back. 4 years later, this
thing
you know,
was him?
I guarantee it was Will. I guarantee he started it
because she is 30 years old.
Okay, all right. Well, Suicide Squad was like five years ago, 5-6.
Will, like I said, I guarantee he messed up. He probably started the whole thing, and she just ran with it because after a while, she's probably like, I'm not about to be the side piece.
Mm-hmm.
And then she said, "Let me get Augie," and then Will was like, "Wait a second, you're not supposed to be doing this to me."
Do you think?
I think that's what it is. That's how it mostly is with most guys.
I think his main... Okay, first of all, when people separate, people go their separate ways.
Mm-hmm.
If you're my ex and you go your separate way and you're with somebody else and I don't feel no type of way whatsoever, I'm like, yeah, do you kudos.
Yeah.
It's not there anymore.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know what I mean? I feel like him as a man having to hear what he heard because
She was flicking it up, too.
Huh?
She was flicking it up, too.
Yeah.
Taking it to award shows, and nobody said nothing.
Yeah, because, you know, he was a family friend.
Yeah, exactly. He was a family friend.
Yeah.
I think... Yeah, I lost my train of thought, but I'm going to go here. I think he's more embarrassed.
Yeah.
That their business is now not only confirmed, but on Front Street. Well, did you see what 50 Cent did to him?
Oh, 50 Cent trolled
him. I don't think that was real. I think 50 shared it because it was funny, but I don't think he did it.
Okay.
But he still trolled
but
him.
It was funny.
That sound like something 50 would do, like, seriously.
That was,
but like,
that was a troll
you
job
you go
and
from
half.
Being, like, America's sweetheart.
Yeah, he was.
Really and truly, to your wife is sleeping with a child. Oh, y'all were about to have a divorce. Oh, at the end of the interview, I'm going to get you back. Oh, you already have multiple times.
What is that, though?
Exactly. That lets you know right there he done did his dirt and he done cheated, too.
Yeah.
But he was able to keep his in line and nobody say nothing and nothing come to the forefront. You messing with children and then...
Yeah, that whole thing made me just feel weird, especially that part.
I just didn't like the way he was looking. Especially like,
he looked like he just got done crying.
But then he looked high. But then at the same time, they both looked like they might have been smoking before they did the interview. Like,
I thought it looked like to me that he was crying 5 minutes before.
That's what I thought. But then I was like, nah, that's probably smoking some Snoop shit. Really and truly.
Seriously. She put them hands on him.
You think what?
So I believe it. The littlest ones are the ones that are the first to put their hands
but
on.
But you know what? There was a... When he did the first Red Table Talk, when he did, last year, he spoke about they were at a barbecue or something with his friends, her friends, this, that, and the other. And he said she, I guess this was early in their relationship, and she said in front of everybody, she told him to shut the F up.
I believe it.
And
she has that hand.
She like, and you can't do that to people. Like, you can't.
Jenna carries that hand.
Relationship, this is unprofessional relationship this is advice. Very... You cannot try to stunt on your significant other in front of people. You cannot do that. But you know what he did? Rolled up a newspaper and swatted her on the head and said, can I talk to you in another room? And she was like, did you just hit me? He's like, yeah, can we talk in another room? God, and he said classic. He told her. He said, I grew up in a house, he said, where my father used my mother like a punching bag. He said, I will not build a house. He's like, where there's anger and violence and cursing. And he was like, I'll end this relationship. And she was like, you're really willing to end a relationship just based off some words, this, that, and the other? And he was like, yeah, because I'm not, that's not how my marriage is going to go. That's not how I'm going to raise a family. Yeah. You know what I mean? So I feel like he is that family man. Yeah. And because in even back his first wife, which I didn't know this either, he went to meet Jada on the set. He always going to be Carlton to me.
Yeah, he's always Carlton
took him to the set where Jada was. He wanted to meet Jada and ended up seeing Cherie, his first wife, and saying
they clicked.
He said he knew that was the one.
They clicked.
And he said they got married, had a kid, this, that, and the other. And later on, he said he seen Jada and he just...
Yeah. Because that was the original
thing. He knew that's where he was supposed to be. How you go to meet this girl and then you meet this girl and you marry her and you have a whole kid and then years later, do. Jada. And then you with Jada. And now y'all one big happy family.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I believe Will is a very family-driven individual. And I believe his feelings were genuinely hurt hearing his wife say how broken she was and how she hadn't felt
that part
so long. That, yeah. Like, and she just wanted to feel good.
She said
like,
it twice.
As a man, like...
Ugh, like, that hurt me.
Yeah.
She's and she stretched it out. I haven't felt... so good in such a long time. And he's like, huh?
Yeah.
I haven't felt so good. Will, please go.
Yeah.
This hurts me, bro. That hurt me to watch.
That was rude.
At that end, that really upset me.
What, ride together, die together?
You're sending the worst message you could possibly send.
Yeah.
To people who don't know no better.
What, mm-hmm. That we're going to stay together no matter what?
No, we're going to be unhappy together and cheat on each other.
I don't think it's necessarily unhappy together. I think maybe they've gotten to that point after 25 years of marriage, like, and they even spoke about this. He said he knows she has his back. And vice versa. You know what I mean? No matter what
we put each other through.
Yeah, exactly. Like, we're here. Like, that's it. And I think maybe that's why relationships lasted as long as they did when our grandparents
Exactly, because they say, you know what?
You know, you cheated. You got a whole other family on the other side of town. Yeah. But, you know, we still... Tell me it ain't true.
Yeah, it's facts, though.
Because, I mean, if grandmothers were headstrong like women are today, would there be 50, 60, 70, 80 years of marriage?
No.
Or would they have been like, you know what, Harold, you done cheated on me too many times. I'm out the dough. I want my child support every Friday.
But here's the thing. Back in the day, they didn't have all that information.
I don't think it's not that they had all that information. I think that it was drilled into people's head that you stayed married and you stayed with your spouse no matter what.
Yeah, because that's how it was back in the day.
There was divorces back then because some people said deuces.
But
I know a lady that was married five times. think she didn't care. Jesus. She literally, she told me, she said she would find a man, have a good time, this, that, and the other. The minute he would do something that she didn't like, and she told him, like, this is a problem, whether it was them drinking or them doing whatever, she was out the door. Wow. Time for another man. Life's too short. Some people had that mentality. Wow. But back to Will and Jada, I think both of them are wrong, because both of them obviously broke the vows of their marriage.
Yeah.
Like, both of them did. Jada, I get why people saying she's wrong. She is a 49-year-old woman who at the time was, what, 44? In an entanglement with the, I think August was like 22, 23 years old. And
great song, too.
History behind, yeah, that Nunya, I had to go back and listen to that. I don't know why I didn't discover this a year ago when he released that song, but I kind of feel like she took advantage of him. She knew what he was going through as far as drugs, and he had been sexually abused as a child.
And his failing health.
Oh, yeah, his failing health, his issues with it. He has mommy issues, like, and that's probably a big reason why he was able to latch on to her like he did. He has mommy issues.
So pretty much he
I think he was looking for something, mm-hmm. and she gave it to him, and then some more.
Oh, a whole lot more.
Like, yeah. You know.
So the whole mommy syndrome.
I think that's a part of it, but if somebody is older than you, it's Jada. What do you mean? Like, you know what I mean? It's Jada. Like, he's a dude. Like,
so like if Nia Long said, hey.
I'm just like, yeah, you want to get some counseling? You know what I mean? Like, but I think she took advantage of the situation. But then at the same time, I feel like he's a grown man.
He could have made the decisions on his own.
Even though he was troubled. But in my spectrum, I feel like both of them are wrong.
Just one came out, one didn't.
Yep.
I can see that now. I see that now.
Yep. And I don't like people in my business either, so I can only imagine how Will feels being the butt of every meme.
Jeez.
Like, you... Yeah. And this is going to be a while till something else jumps
somebody
off.
Somebody else... Yeah.
Yeah, but, like, you're...
I still don't think it's... It might pass the crying Jordan meme.
I don't think it'll go that far.
Did you see they changed the ending with his dad? When his dad was supposed to take him on the road with him, and they changed.
Whoever did the voiceover is a great Will Smith impersonator. Because that
was 12 to hell with him. I'm like, Oh,
and it's sad because, you know, it's... it's Hollywood, man. That's how they do you, bro. It sucks.
Until the next time. Until somebody else do something stupider.
Yeah.
Then, but, like I said, broad spectrum, they both kind
of... They did.
Kind of did. Shady.
Yeah. Like I said, only thing is, she couldn't keep hers quiet.
Yeah.
Because Homeboy wrote a whole song.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. And then...
He did an interview about it.
But the song came out a year ago.
Nobody noticed?
No. And the crazy thing is, in the video, it's like when you're talking on iPhones and it's, you know, the message is coming.
Yeah.
And the name is Corin. That's her middle name. Oh. It says Corin and it has a broken heart emoji.
Oh, wow.
I'm like, how more clear can it get? Because all I did was put in Corin Smith. Jada and Jada came up.
I didn't even know those are middle names, so that's new to me.
Yep. On that video.
So he was out there blowing up spots.
Yes.
Wow.
And I mean, in the song, he talks about her calling and talking about, you know, what's going on, and him saying he got somebody else and she shouldn't be worried. And then he got Jada on the other end talking about, well, I hope she's worth it, this, that, and the other. And it's like,
and you know, it's probably the truth, too.
Yeah, because you remember, I was like, He lying. But nah, he was telling the truth, so.
Crazy, right?
Crazy world. So I hope his album sales spike because of this. Because I feel like that's the only reason.
I would put out an album and call it Entanglement.
Yeah. Entanglement. Might as well.
She she called you an entanglement. I wouldn't really call it a relationship. It was more of an entanglement.
Entanglement with August. Entanglement with August.
That song is
That's those earworms.
That's the same guy that made the coronavirus joint.
Yep. Yes, it was.
That's crazy. But, you know, it is what it is. It's their relationship. We're just bored on quarantine.
We ain't got nothing else to talk
dissecting about. Situations and things. But, I mean, ultimately, if you marry and you step outside your marriage, whether or not y'all separated, you breaking your vows.
Yeah.
Period. Yeah. Period. But they gonna stay together. There's too much money between them.
Yeah, for real.
Too much money.
Well, I got one entertainment news. Is that all you have, Truth?
Yeah, I'm cool.
All right. Anybody know the show Mythbusters?
Yep.
The engineer, the...
Don't forget about Ariana.
I will not forget. Lord, it's on a show. But Grant and Mara, he was the engineer guy you normally seen on the show that was helping them build the different things to debunk myths. He passed away last night. At the age of 49.
Wow.
From COVID?
No.
Oh.
No, this worse. Brain aneurysm.
Oh, that's that unexpected death. Damn.
So, literally, so that's now, is this show cursed? Cause I think they lost the girl.
They did?
Yeah, she died, I want to say last year? She was doing...
Oh, yeah.
She was doing the test on in the salt flats. And her car blew up or crashed. So now you lost two people off of that show. So I don't know what's going on, but a lot of young people. So that is my entertainment.
That's wild.
Yo, I got one more entertainment.
Breaking news.
The same story. I didn't see this, but I see it now. Might shake the country up a little bit. There's an upcoming show. And this is the name of the show.
Oh, God.
Don't yell at me. Don't get mad at me. But the name of the show is Cracker.
What?
And it is a new series that is going to put blacks as slave owners and whites as slaves.
Are you... I heard about that. I heard things about... I'm like... When I said, I'm like... Y'all not gonna, not in this climate.
Can I say it's brilliant? Because it's brilliant.
The upcoming series.
Can I say it's brilliant?
The upcoming series, Cracker, is likely to cause a storm of controversy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. It'll cause controversy now.
What if the roles were reversed in slavery?
Yeah, the roles were reversed makes it controversial.
Oh, I guess it's going to be a movie. It says the movie offers a present-day so-called white supremacist who is magically thrust back in time to an alter... Oh, wow. That'll be a blast from the past. Back in time to an alternate past where Africans enslaved whites and ruled the lands known as America. Well.
I like the concept. I'm with it.
There will be a colorful ensemble of artists including Pitbull, Akon, Lil Wayne, Ice Cube, Guns N' Roses, Flo Rida, RZA, Tyga, Soulja Boy, Ty Dolla $ign, Nicki Minaj, and Diddy.
I think last year this movie would have been.
Yeah, right now it's probably not.
Right now it's slated for fall 2020 release.
Yeah.
I mean, it could work.
Hopefully things are calmed down a little bit more. But.
We'll see.
They got
a trailer, y'all. Yeah, check out the trailer when you get a chance.
Definitely a button pusher.
Yeah. A little bit.
Who wants to push some buttons?
That's what I'm saying. It's like, yeah, let's go ahead and have like 2,000 movies of black people being slaves, but let's have one show about white people being slaves, and now it's controversial.
What's wrong with
but
you?
But do you, I mean, I'm just saying, these are the words that they use. You got to watch how this media works.
Oh, yeah.
They'll tell you, oh, that's controversial. Why? Because we've had the same story. Why is it controversial? Oh, I know why.
Because it's an alternate
ulterior motive?
Yes. That. Yep. Thank you.
You been doing drugs today?
No.
Hey,
no. All right, no. The problem is I had to wear this mask at work all day.
It's working, oxygen depletion.
Working in a warehouse.
My brain not good.
Yeah.
Wearing mask.
No, but I was in the warehouse.
Oh,
all
that's
day.
The worst too. Yeah. It's hot.
And
ugh.
Y'all
got AC over there in the warehouse?
No, God.
Oh, God.
No fans, no nothing.
Yeah, it was a hot one today, boy. In my kitchen at work.
Oh, that's even worse.
Oh, yeah, I'd be in there dying. I'd be like, what's worse, passing out from heat or dying of corona? Which one is it going to be? Because I'm about to snatch this mask off because I can't breathe.
Oh, my God.
So, truth. We're heading to the other realm. Gonna see what's going on in the other realm.
The what?
I know you actually have a drive happening next month.
Actually, I have a drive going on all month. I am collecting school supplies from now. Actually started a couple days ago until August 7th, which is a Friday, and we will be having our third annual school supply drop August 8th at Zephyr Park from 12 to 2 p.m. We're gonna be giving out some school supplies,
socially distant.
Some school supplies, some clothes, some shoes, just some things that'll help these kids who will be going back to school and the kids that'll be staying at home that still need, you know,
papers,
school supplies and stuff like that. So if you would like to donate school supplies, cash, hot dogs, chips, soda, just hit me up on Facebook, Instagram, Truth Davis. If you want to volunteer, let me know. If you are in the community and you have some resources, such as, you know, bounce houses, or you want to come and give out shirts or whatever, holla at me and let me know.
Bounce house is probably not right now.
Why not? People having parties all the time. 2-3 kids in at the time. Bounce around 5 minutes, get out. Very simple. Spray it down. Lights all it down. Next kids. All right.
All of them.
All right.
And I wouldn't be remiss to talk about my little one, Miss Ariana. She is actually starting a art company. Yes, Expressions by Ariana. She has dabbled into the world of steel ball painting.
Not sure what that is, but
If you go on YouTube, they have channels of these.
This is one of these kid things where they watch other kids do it.
No. This is actually, it's a new, I guess it's a painting style that's been happening for a long time, and I guess they fell into this rabbit hole looking at it. And what they do is they put drops of paint on a canvas, and they use the steel ball chain. You pull it, and it makes different things like flowers, birds, trees. So she's actually, they're starting on it. On the weekend, I'm going to post a couple pictures on my Facebook page, TJCM200, showing some of the pictures that she's done so far. So, yes.
My niece is an entrepreneur.
There you go.
Yes.
No, that's good, though, especially starting at this age.
Yes.
Oh, trust me, that girl got a little cash bank.
Yeah.
Yeah,
she's like, you know what? I ain't trying to work.
You remember back in the day when you would get money, your mom be like, let me hold it. I give it to you when we go to the store, you know, if you want some cookies or something from school. No, my niece's money goes untouched.
Yep.
All her money is her money. Nobody touches her money. No. It's amazing how that's grandkids good, get treated.
That's good though.
And we
the day I was like, yo, let me hold some. What you got in your bank, girl?
She got a little bank.
Well, congratulations, Ari.
That's cool.
Yeah, so
yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to seeing some of that.
All right, definitely. I'll post it on my
Facebook. I'm trying to figure out, how does that work?
What's that?
With the steel ball.
Oh, well, like I said, Nick, like if you look up YouTube steel ball painting.
Okay, I'm already just going to do that.
And
you're going down the rabbit hole.
Yeah, you're going, and literally it's thousands of videos. of people making flowers, trees, birds, butterflies. I'm talking about everything.
Hmm. I wish I was creative with art and stuff.
And they go from anywhere from the regular size all the way up to the big canvases.
Oh, chain painting.
Yes. So.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, I know what you're talking about now.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So she's now into that, so.
Yeah, that's really cool.
So like I said, I'll have pictures this weekend on my Facebook page. And I'm still working on Instagram. I'm still not well-versed in that still.
Get with the times.
I know. Everybody's saying, oh, I'm 37, yes, and I'm that's old in Instagram years, so. So I'm still learning it. I'm still Facebook.
It's an 89-year-old lady on Instagram that be working out, and I'm pretty sure she could whoop my behind. Like, straight up. You could be any age on Instagram up there flexing your businesses and making your money. I mean, she cut, too.
Yeah,
she
I believe
cut.
It.
Oh,
yeah.
Like,
I know
I wouldn't tangle with them.
I know there's a lot of older people that do work out hard still.
You know, because it's the old people that want to live, and it's the young people that are like, ah.
I'll get Rona.
Yeah. Let me go to the club. I'm here for a good time, not a long time, you know.
That's so real, though.
And it's just weird. Like I said, you're seeing a lot of people 50 plus that's just, I'm like.
Ripped.
Yeah. It's like, I'm 37. I look like I could be rolled down the street.
Hey, try to get you in the gym.
I ain't going to no gym now.
Nah, you weren't trying to go back then either. But you know, it's all good.
I'm gonna get back in shape. I'm gonna get back to that
dad bod going on.
Yeah, but I want to get back to the high school shape. Well, I was 245, but didn't look 245.
Well, you gotta start somewhere.
Yeah, for real.
Start walking and running. So get that going, but just found out. I guess everybody's favorite Supreme Court Justice, Ruth Ginsburg, the one that goes in the hospital every other weekend.
Yeah, pretty much.
She's in the hospital again.
She got the Rona?
No Rona. Oh. They're calling it an infection. I guess she has some sort of weird bile duct put in her vein or something. So they had to do a little surgery to clean that out.
Huh.
But I do have a little bit of a conspiracy on why Governor DeSantis is mocking up to...
Every time you say Ronnie D, I'm thinking about the DJ from Jersey Shore.
No, but a lot of people, I'm hearing a lot of inside circles that Pence won't be running with Trump again.
What?
Yeah, I think Pence, because I think Pence is starting to see...
I don't want none of this.
Yeah, so I think he's going to back out. So a lot of people are thinking that DeSantis will be...
That would make sense, because he's going super hard for Trump.
Yeah, and he's literally the reason why, because Trump gave him the governorship of Florida. I'm going to be honest, if Trump didn't endorse him, I know everybody said, oh, Gillum was, you know, what he did down in Miami. But... I think Gillum would have been governor.
Yeah. I voted for him.
Man, that was so messy. Oh, that was so messy.
Are you talking about the Miami?
Heck yeah, that was so messy, boy. Somebody set him up, man.
Yeah, they did.
Somebody set him up.
Because they were saying that even though he didn't win the governorship, he was possibly being the leading candidate for vice presidency.
I believe it. No more?
Yeah, no more.
You
call no to the stuff now.
No. But I guess
White House doing that
for real.
No, but I think what's gonna happen is they're saying that the mayor of Atlanta.
Yeah, they heard that she was.
She's a front runner for that.
She's got Corona too.
Yeah, a lot of, not to sound funny, a lot of African American politicians are starting to come down with it.
Well, I don't know who gave the false narrative that we were exempt.
No, I know, but I guess there's a Pinellas County representative that has it now. But yeah, so let's go open everything and let's start really working on
Just because they open stuff don't mean people have to go, though.
Well, except for school.
I'm just saying, like, just because they say, hey, you can go back to the bars doesn't mean that
people... Oh, the bars are closed.
I'm saying before they
close them down again.
It's exercising common sense.
But what happened is, instead of everybody talking about science, everything went to politics.
No, it's common sense.
No, but common sense goes out of the window when politics come in.
No, because not at one point did I say, hey, you know what? I think I'm going to go out to the bar this weekend just because it's open. No, because Corona is very serious and it's still out there. People are very disgusting. So, no, I'm going to stay home.
Yeah, most logical people would do that. Most logical people would be like, I'm not going anywhere. I am staying home. Because pretty much that's all I do with Ari. I pick her up. And we hang out at my apartment. That's it. She might ride her bike outside once in a while, ride around in my little cul-de-sac, but going anywhere? Nope. Her biggest thing is if I order food and we go pick it up. And she sits in the car. That's it. Kids. Yeah, no, and it's sad. And that, and to
the
me,
kids are suffering too.
And that's the biggest thing is, you know, what's going to happen to kids, you know, the kids that when they grow up after all this happens, you know, what's going to happen? How are their psyche going to be after all this? It's going to be scary because they, like I said, they've been taught to be quote unquote socially distant. So we're looking at Idiocracy more and more as this happens. And then, before we go, I want to throw this out here. The national coin shortage.
Digital money.
And I think that's what's going to happen.
Yeah, that's what that is.
It's where, like, I went to get food today. And due to the national coin shortage, please pay with exact change of what your card. I'm like, nah, I got cash. I'm good. And they kind of gave me a little grief on it. Because I didn't have exact change. I was like...
Did they pay you the difference?
No. They gave me change back.
Okay.
They gave me change back. But I know soon it's going to come to the point where they probably won't do that. I'm like, okay, yeah. Then...
A lot of people are losing their change.
And it's like, but where is it going? I got plenty of change at my apartment.
They're taking it.
Yeah, they're so just taking it and putting it away.
And then they can say, hey, wouldn't it be easier if you had a little thing in your arm and it had all your money on it and all you had to do was go like this, just like they did with the phones with Apple Pay and all of that other stuff where people was like, oh man, that's so convenient, all I gotta do is wave my phone. Nobody was like, oh my god, this is new world technology type stuff. People were like, no, this is convenient. And yeah, that's how they get people with convenience.
So and it's gonna come to the point where I said cash will be outlawed. And if that happens,
it's coming.
And I need to start buying.
How else are you supposed to get that one world currency if you still got currency running around?
Well, and a lot. Now
I know.
And we're about to go down the rabbit hole with only a minute left. And I'm just going to throw this out there. All the federal banks controlled by three people. And there's only a few countries that don't have them. And you see who we're having problems with.
Absolutely. That's not a coincidence, bro.
So just follow the bank signs and you'll see what we're talking about. Well, Truth, we did it again.
Yeah.
We survived another episode.
Yo, back to the story we were talking about earlier real quick.
Yep.
Kanye's mother's birthday was today. So,
and today's the day that he pulled out. Wow!
So
wow!
So there's makes sense. We found the correlation. So
poor Kanye, man, that shit sucks, dude.
Yeah.
So hopefully he gets the help that he needs.
He lost his mother and started dating Amber Rose.
Yeah.
Like that was you went from dating AKA college sorority girls
to yeah.
Yeah.
Slut walk queen.
Right? Like, seriously.
Well, Truth, have anything else before we go?
Nah, peace out, y'all.
I'm still voting for Kanye. I don't care.
No, I love Kanye. I will always love Kanye. He gave us classic hip hop music. He really and truly did. But he's just, I hope he finds his way back. I really do.
And on that note, from good old Flo-Hio Radio Studios in Tampa, Surge, thank you, sir.
Sure.
For Truth Davis, my name's Tommy C. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching tonight, guys. And guess what? We will see you next week.